Well, the second recruiter that we talk about is Temi Wu, recruiter at Remix, previously at Clover Health. What Temi has to say is EQ and self-awareness. We all know EQ stands for emotional quotient, so we need to have good amount of emotion or empathy been shown to others as long as we are working with human beings. And the second is self-awareness. How many times we are aware about ourselves? What this means is how much you are aware of yourself that you are job ready, and how many skills you possess that the job description demands. If you possess both of them, and if you possess in a good degree, I think you have a greater chance to score in the eye of Temi Wu. Temi Wu says, I enjoy working with people who have depth of thought. So it's important to me to find engineers who can self-reflect on how previous work experiences have shaped what they value now and what they are looking for next such leap in their career. Now, what this means is, whatever that you have done in terms of job experience or work experience, I think essentially you should be able to speak it out. And let's say if engineers do internship or project, I think are they in a position to explain the entire process of what they have gone through, whether it's internship of 6 months and what they have done. And the second thing is, what is their takeaway from this internship or having done a project of micro, mini or major, whatever they choose to call, right? Anyone can do a generic lip service. Wanting a collaborative, transparent, no BS environment with cool, smart people working on cool, hard problems. What this means is, it will be very easy for anybody to, you know, grasp, memorize an answer, but that won't work. What it will eventually, you know, is going to work for you will be, what is your involvement? What is your conviction? What is that you have done right from morning 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. in the evening if you have worked as an intern? What you have done with the project and what is that you make of it? I think if you are able to explain this, nothing that goes waste. I think if you are able to, you know, speak out with conviction, with the grit and with the hardship that you have done that, I think it should be a self-explanatory thing for the recruiters. Now, this gives Temi Wu confidence. They will be a positive and collaborative contributor to the team. At a small collaborative startup, maybe at Remix, she says that these traits are critical. Whereas it may not be that critical for other company, but when it comes to Remix, Temi Wu says that yes, collaborative work, that means how you gel with the other team members and whether you are a team player or not. I think these key skill sets are very, very important, especially for Temi Wu. It may seem like a common sense, but having a deep, enthusiastic and genuine interest in some aspect of the company would also be of great interest. For example, whether the company's mission, company's product, technical know-how, challenges, work environment, it can be anything. If the candidate is actually prepared, if they have gone through the website of the company and knows about it and maybe align it to their own thought, then I think it will really go deep. You know, what gets better of conversation is those few details. In case if the candidate is good, I think they should be realizing that they need to be equally good knowing that company and where from. I think from the website itself, right? For example, most engineers, you know, Temi Wu goes on to say that most engineers at Remix have a deep love for cities and maybe public transportation. This is what Temi Wu says, that the candidate where they lack is that deep curiosity, that intellect curiosity, which means whatever they have done. For example, the position that Remix talks about here is the one who is interested to go places, you know, love to travel and maybe love to travel by any means of transportation. Those are the ideal candidate to work in Remix. So that's one perspective. Last thing Temi Wu says is ask hard questions either way. So if you are an interviewer, I think you always have something hard to ask. But if you are an interviewee, an engineer, so I think you need to ask really hard questions. You have invested your time going and getting screened there. So it's very, very necessary that how you have fared. You know for yourself how you have fared, but you need to still, you know, validate and cross-verify whether your efforts for that interview has really succeeded well for you. So if you are concentrating on the process and do not want to see the result, I think you should be equally curious to know the result front as well, and might as well ask how you have fared in that interview. So ask hard questions. If you are not prepared, I think start preparing for hard questions, and there are plenty of them.